Well, there's a funny story. The first time I was speaking about this, a fellow researcher stood up and he said, I've often thought about simulating asphalt on the molecular level, but when I have such thoughts, I try to lie down until they go away. Yeah, the whole idea of a molecular simulation is that we're looking at the small scale to learn about the large scale. Yeah, the ingredients for Rhode are familiar. Asphalt binder, aggregate, air voids. But what are the ingredients for these? What are the chemical compounds that you find in an asphalt? And how do they contribute to the mechanical properties that we recognize as being present in a good road? So if we look at just one molecule within the asphalt, it wiggles back and forth as a function of time and eventually seems to rotate to a different direction. If we look at how all the different molecules are doing this at the same time, then from these collective motions, we get ideas. Researchers who are developing next generation asphalts have been looking at our results and saying, aha, this can help me develop a better asphalt. It's exciting that our direct simulation results are having appreciation and influence in the community of people who develop new asphalts.
We were looking at the macro issues, the macro properties of asphalt. Then we looked into the micro properties of asphalt with the advent of superpave and sharp. Now with Mike's research, we've got to look at the nano properties of asphalt. And this is a totally new approach. And hopefully by understanding the basic fundamentals, then we can use that, reverse engineer things, and create new asphalt to get better performance of the highways.
What I think that people will be learning from our model and our results is new ways of thinking about how the compounds that are within asphalts work together to give the mechanical properties.
Looking at the possibilities of what might be with maybe with a molecule that hasn't been discovered as yet.
Just now, we're at the point where we can really begin answering questions about what's going on within an asphalt. This research is possible through funding and conversations with the Rhode Island Department of Transportation, the URI Transportation Center, and the fellow members of the Asphalt Research Consortium. This research wouldn't be possible without the influence of the many graduate students and undergraduate students who have made it part of their own education to be conducting these computer simulations. I personally am very humbled and honored to be selected by the International Rhode Federation as a recipient of the Global Rhode Achievement Award in research.
Michael, you've risen so quickly in this field. You're rubbing elbows with the asphalt greats. And we wish you all the best in your future endeavors.